Hello and welcome. I am Kana Shahid. This is our sixth lecture in the electronics measurement subject, and the module that we are covering is power measurement. Actually, this is our last lecture in power measurement series. So the topic that we are going to discuss today is our power level indicators for program circuits. So till now we have been focusing on power measurement of radio frequency in transmission line. For this in transmission line, there is also audio frequency involved. So the power monitoring of that audio frequency involved is really important. For this purpose, we will be studying about one kind of indicator that can be used for the measurement of audio frequency power. So audio frequency currents will represent speech and music. Actually, we know that speech and music fluctuates rapidly in intensity, so the characteristics of such a power level are fully important to find out, as we are always interested in finding out the characteristics and the steady state condition. It is also important to find out the fluctuation of the power level in the transmission line. So, ordinarily it is accomplished by the audio frequency transmission line and by using a rectifier voltmeter. This rectifier voltmeter, if we use such high ohm, that such a high ohm per volt, that the instrument, measuring instrument, that means the rectifier voltmeter, should not have any effect upon the circuit in which it is used. That means if our measuring instrument is like a rectifier voltmeter, then the resistance of this voltmeter should be such high that it should not affect the transmission line. So the standards have been made and therefore established through the dynamic characteristic of power level indicators for program circuit. So one of the standard is this, where if we have this representation of transmission line like this, where the source and resistance, the line, transmission line has a resistance of 600 ohm, then this is our measuring instrument, where or you can say measuring device, where the rectifier voltmeter of resistance 3900 ohm has been connected to the transmission line through a resistance 3600 ohm. Or alternatively, you can see that the total of these two resistance is connected in parallel to the transmission line. So this is 600 line, this is 600 line, and if we saw alternatively that this total resistance will be 7500 is connected to the transmission line, across the transmission line. But across, this is your rectifier voltmeter. So for impedance measuring purpose, this is our X point, where the input impedance, the incoming input impedance is, because these two are 600, that is 300, and this is 3600. So the total input impedance that is coming to rectifier device, it is actually 3900. So impedance matching can be done here for the maximum power transfer. Using this kind of a standard method, we can measure the audio frequency power available in the transmission line. So obviously the calibration has been done for this rectifier instrument. It has been calibrated in terms of decibel to measure the power. So whatever the frequency available, or you can say the instrument accordingly does not read the actual instantaneous power level of the speech. So whatever power level that we are able to read is, if not the instantaneous power, it is actually the average power for a indicates the mean level based on an average amplitude over a short period of time. So the scale has been calibrated in terms of decibel, and for a steady sine wave voltage with 1 millivolt flowing in 600 ohm has been taken as a reference, and you can see 0 level. So for this we will get a 0 dB voltage, power, sorry, 0 dB power. So the deflection actually obtained when monitoring speech are hard work customary called volume units. So for calibration, the unit has been calibrated as a decibel, and the fluctuation that we are getting is what we are calling it as a volume unit. So volume unit will give you a reading in terms of the whatever power available in your transmission line. So it will represent as a volume unit reading represents the power level in decimal, and that corresponds to the average power level of the speech. Obviously this showing only the average power, but it will show the reading as an instantaneous power only if the monitored signal is sinusoidal and of constant amplitude, then the view reading can be told to be same as the instantaneous power level in decibel. So yes, because the difference has been taken as 1 milliwatt following in a 600 ohm, so does one volume unit correspond to 0 dB dissipated in 600 ohm. Using this calibration and this circuitry and calibration circuitry and the understanding of impedance matching, this is one of the standard of measuring the power of audio signal presenting transmission line. There are many methods available. You can go to the book that I have given you as a reference. I'm again telling you, this is a very old book. You can find a e-book online. You can search through it. And if you have any questions, you can drop in the message, or you can contact me. So this is our this was our last topic in this module. And from the next class, we will continue for the second module. That's all for today. Thank you. Thank you so much.